Hi Pisces, my name is Brooke and welcome to your October 2015 tarot forecast and welcome to Nightbird Tarot. These are general readings for the general public. If you'd like a more in-depth and private reading with me, you can check out my website, nightbirdtarot.com. Pisces, I'm using YouTube's webcam again this month. If the audio is very loud, I apologize. I can't really control the audio so much with the YouTube webcam. I haven't figured it out, so if I'm like, wow, really loud, just turn your volume down. It's real easy. Click, 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 click. You might have to really turn it down because I'm very loud on these videos. Also, I want to make sure everyone knows that these are general readings. Pisces, you know they're general readings. The other signs seem to get all, I just can't believe this. Well, it's a general reading. This could apply, Pisces, you know, could apply to a thousand of you Pisces out there. It doesn't have to be specifically, I can't read a thousand of your minds. So if you do get insight from these readings, you know Pisces, because I'm a Pisces, and Pisces, you're my audience. You're like my girlfriends. So I hope the other signs don't get jealous, but Pisces, you're like my girlfriends. So you get me. You totally understand. But the other signs are like, I just don't understand my... This reading is so negative. I'm sorry. I'm not making this stuff up. This is what the cards are telling me. But they're not specific. They're general. Enough of my speech. So let's carry on, Pisces, and see what's in store for us for the month of October. The first card I've pulled is the Five of Pentacles, which is in your theme or your attributes, your atmospheric elements for the month. The second card I've pulled is the Chariot, which is in your present situation. The third card I've pulled is the Seven of Pentacles, which is in your others or environment position. In your challenge position, we see the Queen of Pentacles. And in your final outcome, we see the Ten of Pentacles. So Pisces, very much about money this month and very much about determination as well. In your atmospheric elements, or what's crowning you, Pisces, for the month, we have the Five of Pentacles. This is essentially feeling without the need, the want, but not having enough. The feeling of not having enough, or the feeling of being left out in the cold, or not meeting financial needs, not having enough to make ends meet, even. There's also the emotional feeling of feeling left out in the cold about something, or feeling as if nobody understands you, or feeling as if nobody else is experiencing this but you. I totally get that. I totally get that. So the need of support for you for the month of October is very important. Of talking to other people about what's going on, of sharing your experiences, or even asking for help. Now, this is the atmospheric elements for the month. This does not mean that this is going to carry on for the whole entire month. Things are going to get better, Pisces. So this is just the feeling or the theme or what's crowning you, essentially, going from September into the month of October. You may be feeling this way about things, of kind of living hand to mouth, or really, you know, stretching your bills out, or really making sure that, you know, you're doing what you need to do to be fiscal responsible or fiscally responsible in your life. It's very much on your mind, very much in the air for you, Pisces. Now, following this card is the card of determination. Presently, Pisces is very determined. You are wanting to bust through this door of feeling left out in the cold, perhaps, or of not being able to make ends meet financially, because the Chariot has appeared. The Chariot is all about control. It's all about determination and courage and the aggression of being determined and not allowing yourself to second guess your efforts or to second guess your desire to charge forward. You want to charge forward. You're determined this month to really leave that behind, to really bust out of that and to progress. It's very important for you, and there's much to be gained in that of success, of being able to overcome obstacles in the month of October. You're on your way. You're on your way, Pisces girlfriends. You're on your way. So here we have in the position of others or your environment is the Seven of Pentacles. So the Seven of Pentacles speaks to me as a card of continuous effort. Keep going. That's the message, especially in dealing with other people, especially in your environment. Show them what you have. Show them what you've got. You can do this, okay? You do not have to take a back seat to anybody. Keep progressing. Be tenacious. Get out there. Tell them what you need. Tell them what you want. The aggression of the Chariot with this card, this is the assertiveness that we need to use in order to progress. And it's one of keep going. If you have not seen results yet, that does not mean that you will not see results this month. Keep persevering. Have that determination that Pisces has. The misconception of Pisces is that we're watery and dreamy and, oh, no, no, no. We are, but deep down inside, we are a warrior Pisces princess, okay? So when we want something, or if we want to go after something, we normally end up getting it because we're so damn persistent. So in your challenge position, we have the Queen. My favorite Queen, which is the Queen of Pentacles, she is all about being in control of her finances, being innovative, being creative. You may have to find creative outlets this month in order to possibly have streamable forms of income, okay? You're in charge of your finances. You're in command of your money. Make sure you know where your money is and you know where your money's going, okay? This also may be an actual person in your life as well. She's in your challenge position. So this may be a person that you may not want to deal with, that you may have to ask for help from. Or this may be a person that may tell you like it is about your financial situation and you just don't want to hear it. But she's coming across as being very generous and being very charitable in her delivery. This may be an actual person. This may be Pisces themselves, whether you're male or female, of making sure that financially you're responsible for yourself. And if you have had financial troubles, you're getting back. The challenge is to keep persevering, to be determined, to get back to that place where you're solid with money and you're solid in terms of making money. So I think this is a beautiful message, especially in the outcome position for Pisces, is seeing the Ten of Pentacles, because the Ten of Pentacles is really being set up for financial foundation. And I really think towards the end of the month for Pisces, whether this is in form of feeling financially more stable in your environment at the end of the month, whether this is also being involved with a family business, family investments, or family helping you out financially, something is going to be given, something is going to be received. You're going to feel like your footing is back, financially stable once again, and having that completion of, I did it. By Halloween, I did it. Everything's good. You know, I've got a little bit of fun money to play around with. Feeling financially stable again towards the end of the month for Pisces, and that's the message of regaining your foot again of being in control and being in command of your finances. And this feeling that you may have going into the month of October of not having enough is a feeling. It does not necessarily mean it is forever, okay? It's just a feeling. So good luck to you, Pisces. Keep me posted. Have a great month. Happy Halloween. Thank you for all your love and support, my Pisces girlfriends out there. Even if you're a guy, you're still one of my Pisces girlfriends. So thank you for your support. Check me out on patreon.com if you'd like to be a patron and support my channel. Also, check out my website, nightbirdtarot.com. Check me out on Facebook, Twitter, and Google+. Have a great month. Take care, and I'll speak to you soon.